Hi all, I'm Sid, and this is Micromax's answer to the Xiaomi Redmi Note 4. It is called Micromax Evoke Note. Now, this phone has some good things about it and some things that are not so good. We'll be talking all about that in this quick unboxing and first impression video. So, let's first take the lid out. I'll snap it off its jacket. And by the way, if we talk about the jacket here, you get the phone's illustration here, which is actually embedded here. It's engraved, so you can touch and feel it. Apart from that, the name of the phone is written along with Micromax's logo on top. Now, if I talk about the box, it's sealed. I forgot. Let me get my cutter. By the way, don't try this at home. Your hand can get cut. If I open this box now for you, taking the lid out, you see the phone lying there, and I'll keep this phone at a side for a while I take a look at other things you get. So the first thing I can see is a SIM ejector tool attached next to the tray itself. Let me turn the tray out. So if we take the tray out, you get access to this box, and this box has a cool freebie for you guys. And as you can see, you get a free cover with it. This is something that a lot of people would appreciate. They don't have to buy a spare cover. Micromax already gives you a cover alongside. You also get the documentation here, brochures, secure vault feature. I'll tell you what that is in just a minute. And you also get on this phone, along with this phone rather, a screen guard. Another freebie for you. Now, enough of the freebies, let's talk about the main contents which you get in every smartphone. You get a micro USB cable and you get a power adapter. You plug them together and you have a charger. You also get alongside a pair of headphones which look quite cool, in fact. You see here, they've got a piston design is what I can see. But let me keep them on the side for now. So, the inbox contents are as follows. You get a SIM ejector tool. You get a couple of sheets of paper which are the documentation. You get a free back cover which is made up of plastic. You also get screen guard, you also get a charger with an adapter, you also get a pair of headphones. But the most important thing of them all is the smartphone itself. So now let's quickly wrap the box up and let's focus on the Micromax Evoke Note. So now in my hands is the Micromax Evoke Note, Micromax's answer to Xiaomi's Redmi Note 4. And the price of this smartphone is under 10,000 bucks, so it directly competes with the Note 4. And compared to that, it has got a good design, so it does put up a good fight. In fact, it's got a brushed metal back finish, as you can see. I'll tilt it at the slide for you to see. There's a texture here. The top and bottom, however, are made up of plastic, but the phone feels very good. It looks very good. The front is made up of a non-scratchable Gorilla Glass 3. That's what was written on the box. And it's got a 5.5-inch Full HD display as well. So in terms of design and in terms of display, the phone is at par with the Note 4. It also has a fingerprint scanner within this home button, which is quite fast, as you can... Okay, it's not that fast. I thought it would be fast. Okay, so this is not a fingerprint scanner issue. It is actually a software issue, and I'm glad that this got covered in the camera. As you can see, the fingerprint scanner did not work. Now, let me try it one more time. And it works now. So there is an issue with the software. I'll come to it a bit later. Let me first talk about the fingerprint scanner. So it is the first issue I have with this is its physicality. As you can see, just listen to the sound that it makes. It feels very cheap. Secondly, this fingerprint scanner also enables you to get into your secured vault, which is a secured place to place your videos, pictures, apps, and other documents. It was the same thing that we have seen in cool dual Micromax Dual 5 review. So go and check that out. And now I would want to talk to you guys about the processor of the smartphone. Now this smartphone under 10,000 bucks gives you 3GB of RAM, while Xiaomi under 10,000 bucks gives you 2GB of RAM on the Redmi Note 4. But Xiaomi uses a Snapdragon 625 CPU. This smartphone uses a MediaTek processor. Now I don't know how they are going to compete with Xiaomi with a MediaTek processor, but again, everyone to their own. This is not a full review, it's just a first impression. I'm just telling you what all it has. One more thing it has is Android Marshmallow. And I'll show it to you. It's not got Nougat. The only issue is that Micromax is pretty slow to update their smartphones. So I would have loved to have Nougat on board. But right now you have Marshmallow. But as I showed you in the start of the video as well, Micromax software has always been buggy. And I don't know about this, but as of now, I do feel that it is going to be buggy. But again, I'll save the latter part for my review. What I would tell you, however, is the amount of bloat you get. You get My Geo app here, you get all the Google apps, you get Uber. I have not installed a single application on this phone. In fact, I set this phone up 2 minutes back. So you get all these applications pre-installed. You get a lot of games as well. You get shopping apps. You get a lot of applications basically. And to top that up, you also get this Micromax, Micromax World Around. Now this basically is your assistant. It can do a lot of things for you. It can book you movies. It can tell you where, you know, nearby things are. You got it. If you're looking for, say, a restaurant, as you can see, the software is so damn buggy. Even the keyboard is not popping up. I know there is no internet connection, but at least the keyboard should have come up. So I won't be touching much on it. I would save the other things for my review. What I would tell you, however, is the camera on the back is of 13 megapixel. And the camera on the front is of 5 megapixel. So the cameras are at par. The highlight of this smartphone, however, is its battery as well. It's got 4000 mAh of battery and it does aim to last a lot long. That is it from the first impression. It's got a good design, it's got a good, it gives you a good amount of RAM, the pricing is fine, you get secured wall feature, you get good cameras, but the only issue I have with this smartphone are two. Number one, the processor. I would have loved to see a Snapdragon processor under this price. And number two, it's Micromax. The software is pretty buggy. As you can see, now the keyboard is not coming as well. So there are some issues that Micromax phones have. I'm happy to see the company back, but again, if this is what you call a return, you need a lot more. This is all from the first impression. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you did not, feel free to give it a thumbs down. Do share this video with your friends, but most importantly, stay subscribed to 91 Mobile. I'll see you in the next one. Ciao.